terms of achievements I wanted, yeah, it's pretty good. I haven't won 2009 for some 26 races. This year I've won 12, I think. But the high quality races, you know, 2 stages of Giro, 5 stages of Tour, green jersey on the world, you know, and scale the price again. So in terms of quality of wins, yeah, it's probably my most, well, not probably, yeah, for sure, my most successful season. As far as I can remember, I don't think ever, nobody's ever won Pro Tours in rainbow jersey, so that'll be nice to show it off. I'm not too optimistic about a definite win tomorrow, but we've got a strong team, so hopefully.
Hey, you've got a great team that you've really grown with. It's really embraced you with support, unparalleled, it seems, in the Pro Peloton today. And this is a bit of a swan song to have the team disbanded after this, isn't it?
As we in the last month have all been pretty upsetting, but you know, we've shown how all the riders and the staff, we all get on so well that we still, even though we know we're all going to separate, we all still work together and still continue with the results, you know, and that's been incredible. You see it the Tour of Britain, at the Vuelta, and then 2 world champions, you know, we've kept on going even though. And the team's been faithful, so.
Yeah, I spoke with Brian just a minute ago before you went out on your spin, and he said maybe he's trying to convince himself, but he said almost, maybe it's better this way, that we had such a successful season that it would almost seem impossible to
yeah, but
to
we,
top it.
No, we said that the last 4 years. Every season we said it's impossible to go better, and we've always gone better.
Yeah.
That's because we've had an incredible group. We've had most of the guys, most of the core guys have grown up together. We're all the same age, me, Tony, you know, for instance, Bernie, we've all been here at the same time, and we've grown together, you know.
Could you tell me about your first bicycle, your very first racing bike?
First racing bike was a Peugeot. Can't remember what model it was. Yeah, down tube shifters and that still. And
6 speeds?
Yeah, but since then I always looked after my bike. Always was always immaculate, you know, and what I wanted to make my living on. So, you know, there's only one tool that I'm going to do this on, and that's a bike. So, you know, I think details in it, details in how it works, for instance, that's a given. You know, if my bike doesn't run properly, that's affecting my job, my life, you know, and so I have to do that. But yeah, I'm quite into detail with how things are. I'm very tidy. I like things to be clean and neat. And so that goes for the aesthetics of the bike, the colours of the bike, all that, you know. I'll give you an example of a detail that I love, is the fact in the Venge, it's designed so the battery from the Di2 Shimano goes in the seat tube. If you look, most bikes, probably every other bike has the battery showing. For me, it takes away the curves of the bike, you know. The bike's design, obviously, there's a lot of time and money gone into designing that, and it's aerodynamically perfect, so why stick a big battery on? But that's gone into the design. It fits in the seat tube. It just looks a bit more pleasing to the eye, and that's what I like about it.
Yeah. What do you get your arms like that for?
Because he's huge.
Put him close to your body.
No, I don't want it to look like Poe.
Oh, it's blurry. Wait, one more.